really like to be out here in our garden. I like to be out in the green, taking care of the plants and harvesting nice fresh produce. But being a smallholder farmer is difficult and you face a lot of different challenges. What is a smallholder farmer? Yeah, that's a very good question.
Smallholders are farmers who manage areas varying from less than 1 hectare up to 10 hectares. Despite its smallest scale, smallholder farming is very important for the local community. In some parts of the world, such as sub-Saharan Africa, they can produce up to 80% of the total food supply. However, unfortunately, smallholders are facing challenges that could differ from one country to another. Some of the common challenges are climate variability, lack of agricultural infrastructure, soil degradation, and poor economic conditions.
Wow! I didn't know that so many people were relying on smallholder farmers. But what about food security?
Good question. According to the FAO, food security is defined as that all people at all times have physical, social and economic access to enough, safe and nutritious food that can support an active and healthy life. The concept of agroecology is closely linked to food security. It promotes the equality of people, the connection between smallholder farmers, increases the yield and reduces the use of pesticides and herbicides. Apart from increasing the economic situation of smallholder farmers, this will also increase the access to healthy and varied nutrition.
Agroecology seems like a really nice concept. It sounds like something that could be beneficial for smallholder farmers. Is that right?
Yes, that is right. Agroecology promotes diverse and efficient systems which are knowledge intensive and not input intensive. In that way, agroecology increases the ability of smallholders to have a stable and diversified production and to be independent from external influences, which often drive market prices but disregard food security. In this way, agroecology supports food sovereignty, which is the people's right to define their own agricultural and food policy.
In this video, we've talked about the connection between smallholder farming and agroecology.
We've seen that agroecology is also of high importance here, thanks to its holistic approach.
Stay tuned for our next episodes.